This is the appointed time and we have a quorum. So now election of chairman and deputy chairman for the panel on administration of justice and legal services. Only one ballot nomination was received. Mr. Martin Liao, proposed by Mr. Jamie, seconded by Ms. Maggie Chan. Since Mr. Liao is not the chairman or deputy chairman of any other panels or a relevant government advisory body, so here I announce that Mr. Liao is elected chairman of this panel. Congratulations. Thank you for your support. Now we will elect the Deputy Chairman of the AJLSP for the 2023 session. The panel secretary has issued a notice notifying members that by the deadline, only one valid nomination was received. Ms. Yong Ho Yan, nominated by Mr. Jimmy Ng and seconded by Ms. Carmen Khan. Since Ms. Yong is not the chairman or deputy chairman of other panels or other relevant government advisory bodies, according to the rules of procedures and the House rule, I announce Ms. Yong elected as the deputy chair of the AJLSP. Congratulations. Now, agenda item 2, application for late membership of the panel. Members, please note that after the deadline to indicate their wish to join the various panels for the 2023 session, Mr. Dennis Leung has written to me on the 16th of January, expressing his wish to join this panel. Mr. Leung's letter was issued to members earlier today. Do all members agree to accept this late membership application from Mr. Dennis Leung? No objection. Then we will accept this application. Please notify Mr. Dennis Leung. Agenda item 3, schedule of meetings for the 2023 session. In the last session, our regular meeting was held on the fourth Monday of every month at 4:30 in the afternoon. So do we all agree to continue to schedule our meetings based on the above principle? The proposed meeting dates are provided to you here. I would also like to ask if all members agree to the proposed meeting dates. The proposed dates are tabled. Do we all agree? If yes, then the schedule of meetings will be officially distributed to members later after the meeting. Items for discussion for the next meeting. Our next meeting is scheduled at 4:30 on the 27th of February. Only one agenda item, Criminal Procedure Amendment Bill. Are there any comments regarding this discussion item? And do members have any other items proposed for the list of outstanding items for discussion? You can raise them now. Ms. Kong Yuk Foon, as regards to the land registration ordinance. To my understanding, I understand that this will not affect land ownership. Is it possible for the government to discuss this item in our meeting this year? It means on the policy level. No, I'm referring to the amendment to the legislation. What is the progress of the amendment? We can raise this issue to the administration. But for this panel, our terms of reference is on a policy level. But I remember that last year we also had a list of outstanding items for discussion. So last year we had intended to discuss those items in our panel meetings. Many of those items were quite important for those in the legal sector. So I would like to know whether we can expedite the discussion process so that we can cover more items in this meeting. Any example? Well, last year we have items that are left to be discussed, such as the arbitration, mediation matters, and also for class action, and also 13, training for judges, judicial officers and legal officers, development of and support for the Hong Kong legal profession, matters relating to the legal aid and enduring powers of attorney, etc. But I see that these items are included in our list this year. I just would like to say that if we can expedite the process of discussion, then we can cover more topics. I understand your view. I will discuss this with the administration. Thank you. Next, Dr. Priscilla Leung. I'm not sure if it is a technical problem. I couldn't press the button. I would like to follow up on Chief Justice, what he said in his speech yesterday regarding a proposed working group on streaming court proceedings live. I think this is an important issue. I hope that through the chairman, we can have a discussion with the judiciary to see where this is headed, and we want to provide our views on streaming court proceedings. Do we have any issues that we need to pay particular attention to? Perhaps we can refer to experiences from other overseas jurisdictions. I hope that members can express their views so that this working group can take into account our views. In the near future, our panel will have a meeting with the judiciary. By then, you can raise your concerns with them as well. Next, Dr. Junius Ho. Thank you. Well, I would like to follow up on item 15 and 18 regarding the development of and support for the Hong Kong legal profession and legal education and training. And also for item 8, progress on facilitating the legal cooperation and convergence of legal practices within the GBA. So that is item 8, 15, and 18. these three items are interrelated, but at the end of the day, it is about how we can implement them. We are closely connected with the GBA, so I hope that item 8 can be discussed sooner rather than being discussed in the fourth quarter. And for the legal examination, it will be rolled out soon with about 800 candidates. So if item 8 can be discussed sooner, then there will be benefits for sure. And if we are discussing item 8, then item 15 and 18 are also related, so perhaps they can be discussed together. Yes, I will reflect this view to the administration. Next, Ms. Carmen Khan. Thank you. In the document, item 14, trainings for judges, judicial officers, and legal officers, on the 30th of December, the latest interpretation of the national security law. I think that for this item, we can push this item forward for discussion. Perhaps we can invite representatives from the relevant departments who explain the situation to us. Also, items 19 and 20, matters relating to legal aid and implementation of LRC report on enduring powers of attorney. The preparatory work for the amendment bill is ready. So on the policy level, what considerations do we have? So items 14, 19, and 20, please. Thank you. Deputy Chair, I would like to follow up on what Dr. Priscilla Leung mentioned, the use of technology in court. So currently, audio recording, the DAC system is used in courts for audio recording. So is it possible to provide simultaneous interpretation in courts so the judges or counsels will be able to check on the progress of the proceedings in a timely manner? Next, on the international mediation, I raised this item on the 25th of January 2022, matters relating to mediation. I would like to know more about the updated information on the mediation initiatives in this regard. Next, Mr. Holden Chow. Thank you. I agree with what Ms. Carmen Khan said. Because of the interpretation of the national security law by the MPC, in the future, the use of the national security law has been detailed. I would like to know whether later on in the year, will trainings be provided for judges so that they can understand the latest situation? And in due course, we will be informed of the latest progress. Second, item 13, technological advancement in the judicial process. To my understanding, in the middle of last year, the court has applied the case management system And I also learned from legal ear that e-litigation will be rolled out on a large scale. So relating to technological advancement or the use of technology, is it possible for us to be informed of the latest development and arrangements? Because I'm sure that members of the public and legal professionals are quite concerned about this. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chow. Next, Ms. Maggie Chen. Since Dr. Priscilla Leung has already spoken once. Thank you, Chair. I'd like to ask about CAP 159, Legal Practitioners Ordinance, because the Chief Executive mentioned that he would proactively consider amending the ordinance. I'd like to know whether it should be discussed at this panel or another one, because if this is the right avenue, then perhaps we should discuss that. This should be the right channel. So you would like to add this item? Yes. This is a new item to the list. Okay. Any others? All right, Dr. Priscilla Leung. Thank you, Chair. Yes, I'd like to follow up on a similar issue. The Secretary for Justice said on an open occasion that in relation to interpretation of the national security law, they would very proactively consider whether we have local legislation in conflict with the national security law. I'd like to invite the DFJ to meet with us in due course and discuss with the panel where they will start and how they're going to proceed in a gradual and orderly manner. And that may include amendments to the Legal Practitioners Ordinance. Yes, because that is quite pressing as well. The Secretary of Justice doesn't mean just that he will. He has said on many occasions that he will very proactively consider other pieces of legislation as well. We would like to know the direction of his study. And item 18, proposed by myself, to discuss the proposal of introducing a public examination as an alternative to the postgraduate certificate in laws. I follow up on this item every year, so I'd like to know the progress. And the Law Society may have some progress to report to us. Thank you, Ms. Carmen Can, Chair. I'd like to make myself clearer in relation to point 20, because I was a bit confused by the translation. Now, enduring powers of attorney, we already have a piece of legislation on that, but for continuing powers of attorney bill, so that is the personal care continuing powers of attorney bill, I'd like to follow up on that, because enduring powers of attorney can only deal with personal assets, but continuing care will involve continuing powers of attorney. There are aspirations in the society, and I hope the administration can explain this to us. Ms. Maggie Chen, I'm on point 15. The last paragraph is a majority of the law firms in Hong Kong amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. There is no proposed time for discussing this. Now, with resumption of quarantine-free travel across the boundary, SME law firms need assistance. If you have yet to have a discussion time, then we have to support small and medium-sized law firms. They are awaiting policies from the administration. We don't even have a discussion time. In fact, they are all in deep waters. Dr. Priscilla Leung, item 19, Chair. Also my pet subject. This panel, the member representing the legal profession have said time and again that the disbursement of funds is too low, too slow, and this is a fact. The financial situation of some law firms engaged by the legal aid department. We'd like to know how come sometimes it took even up to 7 or 8 years for the fee to be settled. All right, thank you very much. I'm going to meet with the administration and the judiciary very soon to discuss the work plan for this panel in 2022-23. I will take into account views expressed by members. Now, if members have other suggestions, you can write to our secretariat if you have any new ideas. Next item, AOB, I don't have any. So, meeting adjourned. Thank you.